Hi friends, today I'm going to show you guys how to attach your AdventureWorks data warehouse database to your SQL server. So it's going to look something like this. So this is really helpful for training and practicing. So you already have the tables populated, so you don't have to spend some time to create a new table and populate it. So the data is all already here. So just like this, you see. So you can just play around with this data, right? Just for the practice purpose. So I'm going to show you guys how to attach this database into your SQL server. So this is going to be a local host. So I'm just going to connect the database here. And then you see, I just put a dot, or I can also type local host, right? So both are the same thing. So I'm going to show you that, right? So, but before that, I'm going to show you guys where I took these files. I'm going to drop the link for these two files in the description. So I'm going to show you guys two options. One is using a restoration approach, and the other one is using a database attach approach, right? First things first, database restoration approach. So in Microsoft, so there is a bunch of sample databases they have. So it's in the description again. So you can choose any one version, choose the latest one, I guess. So you can download it. I have already downloaded it to my local, so I'll just use that. And then when you download it, you have to move it to your program data folder. Likewise, I will come to the .mdf files in a few minutes. This is for attaching your database. So first, once you have this data downloaded, all that you have to do is go to your database engine. Right, hit dot or hit localhost, doesn't matter. Connect, right? I go to databases, right? Click on the database, right click, restore database, right? So it's going to show you source and then destination. Source is going to be from a device, right? It's in your local, so it's a device. So let's select the source. So backup media is a file, there's a URL also. You can do both, it doesn't matter, I guess. So add. Then once you add it, so I'm gonna put the downloaded file, whatever you got it from that Microsoft website, put it in the program data, I guess, just for the you can put it in different places, I guess, in program files, MS SQL Server also, but just for the video purpose, I'm just gonna drop it in the program data. Like you see here, there is a AdventureWorks DW2017.BAK backup file. So I just got this file from the from this place here, from this Microsoft docs.microsoft.com. So use that, hit OK. So now that you have the file here, hit OK again. And now you can rename your database the way you want. So I'm just going to keep it like that. So AdventureWorks DW2017 is the name. So this physical data file that you have here, the backup file, is going to be added to your the databases list here on your left hand side, right? So let's give a hit OK. It's going to take a few seconds. Yep, so database restored successfully. Hit OK. And there you go on your left hand side, right? So you see, you have all your tables, you have all your dimension tables, you have all your fact tables. It's all ready to go. You can just go ahead and directly create a model from this, and it's super easy to play around with that, right? It's all pre-populated. For example, let's just open this fact table, internet sales. So see, everything is there. So everything, it's just, you just need to plug and play kind of thing, right? So this is one way of doing it, right? So how do you add, if you have a MDF file, .mdf file, right? Like the way here, what you see here in the other place. So you can also do it in this way also. It's not gonna hurt. So let's say you have an .mdf file, right? So again, download it, put it in the program data folder. And then again, let's go back here, right? Then you just need to, since I already have it, I'm just gonna delete it, and then you know what, I'm just gonna add it again. Just delete this. Okay, so I think it's gone. So all right, so now that that database is gone, now I'm gonna show you guys how to go ahead and attach this, right? So attach a database. Previously we saw restoring the database. Now I'm gonna show you guys attaching a database. And there is also another way, I guess, using a script to put all the things in there. but this is the easiest approach, right? So for you to attach a database, click the attach and then go here. So again, very similar. So databases to attach, it's gonna ask you that. Again, I'm just gonna put the files in the program data here. And then I'm gonna have my file somewhere here. I need to go here. I have my downloaded file in a folder. So I just need to copy this file, move it into the program data. All right, so it's here. So adventureworks.mdf, it's perfect. So I'll go to my SQL server. It's gonna ask me for locating it. And select it again. I can see my MDF file. Select it, hit OK, and that's it. Hit OK again. And there you go. So you have your MDF file also attached here. So again, this is another way of doing it, guys. So yeah, so let me know if you have any questions. I'm gonna drop the links for those two files that I used. So please feel free to go ahead and try it out. If you haven't installed SQL Server, I'll drop a link for that as well. So install it, download it, plug and play, and practice your SQL. Thank you guys. See you in a different video.